Master, we recognize that you are the giver of life. You not only create, you not only sustain, but you give new life. Thank you that you have preserved these two individuals for this moment. Thank you that you have brought them together in your providence. We begin this ceremony by asking you to be here.
When you need a place to hide, I'll be there for you. I'll be there for you. A constant friend for you. I'll be there for you. Time will turn just like a page, and there will come a day. Just remember that I'm never far away. Just call my name. I'll be there for you. I'll be there for you.
It is you that brings two individuals together and makes them one. This is a new moment in history. And so we ask now, while it is silent, that you would allow your forgiveness and grace to flow across us and give us a new moment, a new time. In this moment, when we make vows, when we say words, when we clasp our hands together and exchange rings, do the work of bringing these two individuals into one. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
I'll be there for you. I'll be there for you.
Gathered here in the sight of God to join this man and this woman into the bonds of holy matrimony. The scripture says that don't enter into this unadvisedly or lightly, but discreetly, wisely, and in the fear of God. It is in that atmosphere, in that place, that we come and bring these two together.
My dearest David, paths that you and I have chosen have not been the easiest, but they are perfect because they led us to each other. In heartbreak and in joy, I prayed and longed for God to lead me to this choice to choose you as my husband.
Words carry very powerful meanings for me. We have quite a few pet names for one another, right? Boo, Bay, honey, baby, cutie booty, that other one that I can't say in public gatherings. And then there are some words that explain the kind of relationship that you have with me. Best friend, lover, partner, and now wife.
I praise God tonight as His will is being fulfilled. Through the pressures of the present and the uncertainties of the future, I promise you and God my faithfulness to stand beside you through all of life's experiences, seeking after the heart of God.
wanted to look for some other words with deep meanings to speak as pledges to you in our vows. So I borrowed from our Gaelic ancestors to bring these words to life now. There's a word that says makushla, which literally means my pulse. It's for the person who makes your heart beat. I'm not going to cry. I promise that my heart will always respond to you.
I promise to care for you in sickness and health. I promise to be there with you in the richness of life and the humbleness of failure.
There's also one that says Masherga. It means my eternal love, and sometimes used as the term soulmate. I promise to hold on to you forever, even as we follow Jesus into eternity.
I pledge my honor to you by seeking Christ first in our marriage. I vow to respect you and work with you as your partner. I promise to make you laugh. I promise to listen to your concerns and call you out on your bullshit.
There's another one, a Keda shark, right? This means my first love, or my one and only. And I vow to you, I vow that you will be all I'll ever want or need. My heart will always find home in you. There's another word, astor, which means my treasure. I promise that I will never chase money or fame harder than I chase you. But the last one has no direct English translation. It's called Marunhak. It literally means my secret love. It means the only love that you know, the love that you hide in the secret parts of you, the love that you know like you know your own bones or blood.
I vow to love you today and every day for the man you've been, the man you're becoming, and the man you are. I promise to do all these things and more all the days of my life.
I return you to me. You into me and I into you. No longer divided, but now one flesh. My heart, my love, I choose you. And I always will.
Guys, I promise to always accept you for who you are and support you in everything and love you for who you are and support you in all your dreams and be there for you always.
Guys, I know that this is new and it's going to take some time to settle into. But I want you to recognize that this joining together means safety for you. It will always be safety for you. You have a home and people that love you. And whatever comes your way, we intend to make sure you have safe harbor for now and forever.
Father, you are the uniting God. You are the restoring God. And we thank you that you are uniting this family together and restoring everything that is broken. We see in your bridal love and in your forgiveness your work in flesh and blood. Let your love permeate our hearts and hands and our lives as we bind it together now. Give us your forgiveness, give us your grace, and give us newness of life. We ask in the name of the Father, and Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. For as much as you, David, and Lauren have consented together in holy wedlock, and have witnessed the same before God in this company of friends and family, and have given and pledged your vows, exchanged rings, and bound your heart and hands together and family together, I pronounce that you are husband and wife In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, you may kiss the bride. Just one time.
This feels like home.
Happy Hunger Games, and may the odds be ever in your favor.
That was-